그러니까 세월이건 앞으로도 유럽 그룹이나 and I show you both evidence. We need to know the fine genetic properties have to understand natural phenomena when the system is so complex or unknown interaction conditions. In this figure shows the predators of elemental particles. Nobody can trace by bubble bath. Nobody can obtain proper data which reveals how the particles interact with each other. So, theoretical physics have to start from some assumption based on symmetry. Physicists try to find symmetry in the study of complex systems because we can approach them more easily by reducing the size of base space or dictating their interactions by an abstract algebra. Symmetry becomes more important in the study of neural phenomena because many computational processes in the brain relate to symmetry. I found this example from my daughter's video game, Dora the Explorer. The goal of this game is to find the proper image at this position, and you can guess that the answer is this circle because of the symmetry or continuity with others. In this case of pattern recognition or categorization, the mechanism of them can be understood in the terms of symmetry. There is the key is to separate the symmetry and asymmetry part between patterns. Then the symmetry part becomes the major component to categorize them. Like this, there are many interesting problems in neuroscience related to symmetry. And I show you one good example in which neural phenomena can be understood by using only symmetry properties. The problem is the pattern formation in the visual maps. This was the subject of my PhD thesis and the result was published in this paper. This video shows the configuration of functional maps in the brain. It is said the modern studies of the brain may started from to find the relation between specific brain function and brain area. Especially, the functional maps in the sensory area or motor cortex area are much studied because the neurons in this area make clear response to external stimuli and form evident pattern structures. Among them, orientation preference and ocular dominance are the two typical primates found in visual cortex in this area. The neurons in VM have the tendency to make a strong response to external stimuli when they experience visual information of orientation patterns along their preferred directions. In this video, the neurons at the end of the electrode have orientation preference for these vertical images. And orientation preference represents the configuration of orientation preference at a particular level by different colors. In this video, the neurons in red have the orientation preference for these horizontal images. Naturally, we can ask why and how orientation selectivity develops in the primate visual cortex area. Some animal experiments have shown that this development of orientation selectivity based on genetic factors, but we can build on unsupervised learning model in which orientation selectivity develops depending on the statistical properties of visual inputs. And this is related to the mechanism of symmetric breaking in physics. Such orientation selectivity, we don't have to detect the pick out shape of objects by detecting the edges of images. The ODI maps have some typical categories. The map formation does not fix or develop for several weeks after animal birth. And the neurons have similar orientation selected with closed labels like this arrangement. There are the singular points, the called pinnules, in which, around which orientation preference changed by vertical of 108 degrees around a closed loop. And there are linear zones which are and linear zones are periodic patterns in which iso-orientation contour lines is straight and running parallel for considerable range. Besides, the contour lines have the tendency to meet with boundary at right angle. This problem of malformation in the visual cortex is one of the studied problems in cervical neuroscience, and so many models are suggested to explain this phenomenon. In fact, there are so many different models which can yield successful visual malformations, even though some of them seem to be independent with the real neural mechanisms. Somebody worried about this and to suggest to find the proper model by comparing with more detailed experimental data, but we give an answer about this. You can distinguish them just by comparing their emergent pattern structures, because the typical pattern structures of visual maps are not determined by specific neural mechanisms, but universality. And we suggest the theoretical method in which typical properties of visual maps can be explained systematically by using only symmetric properties. Maps conscious theory is an energy function which describes OD map formation. Then the OD map formation would generate a low value for this configuration because of the discontinuity and disposition. Energy function should generate the same value for this and this configuration in which the neurons and the wall neurons have the same difference with three-quarter angles. That is, the energy function should be invariant under the global gated transform. Considering the invariance under the local gated transform, the energy function should be described by this general form or the Ginzburg-Landau energy function. This energy function is the necessary conditions of well-valid models of visual malformation, and we can derive this from the models in a continuum approximation. You can explain the universality of visual malformation and obtain the theory by another way. In this figure, this figure shows on path of line on a curved surface according to the general relativity theory. And this figure shows an arrangement of orientation preference in the primary visual cortex area. These phenomena do so difference, but you can approach them by a common method in differential geometry, or the five-bound theory. Five-bound theory helps to find optimal path or optimal configuration on a manifold structure. And in the viewpoint of differential geometry, the only one difference between these two phenomena is the topology of spaces. In this case, the target space becomes the page space or pivot space. And in this case, U1 or auto-gated space becomes the page space. And we can predict that if there is the physical system which have the same topology with the OP maps, they would share the statistical properties, and there is a well-known system to exist. That is the two-dimensional XY model. Indeed, the two systems share so many statistical properties. First, a pinnule found in OPMAP is an equivalent structure with vortex or infinite vortex in XY model systems. We can calculate this energy of pinnule formation by using the result of the classical XY model. If this energy, pre-energy is obtained by positive, pinnules will be unstable. And such instability of pinnules was first introduced by Wolf and Geiger in 1998. And this figure shows the annihilation of pinnules by collision in simulation. classical XI model does not have the feature of periodic patterns, but you can explain this by using XI model having longer and relative interactions, or this by using this Gainsborough equation. And the emergence of periodic patterns relates to this vector compression term, and the wavelength of them is obtained by this equation. This figure shows the autocorrelation of orientation preference obtained in animal experiments. And analytically, this is obtained by this equation, where zero node meets the zero space function. Without this zero space function, the outcome is the same in the result of the classical XI model having the nearest neighbor interactions. I said that the contour lines of optimal have the center meet with cortical boundary perpendicularly, and this can be explained derived easily from the equilibrium condition of the Gainsborough energy function. And this is similar with the behavior of magnetostatic fields near conductors. Ocular dominance map is another typical map found in VR. The neurons in VR have the tendency to receive visual information only from left to or right eye. And ocular dominance map reflects the distribution of ocular dominance by two different colors. I said that the OP map formation can be understood by the analogy with the XI model. And similarly, OD map formation can be approached by using ID model system. But some experimental results show that the OP and OD maps are not independent but correlated. The correlation originates from the competitive relation between two functional properties because of the limited amount of resource or synapses. That is, if a neuron uses its whole synapse to have orientation selectivity, it cannot have ocular dominance or other functional properties. And from this normalization condition, we can build a joint model of OP and OD maps by using Heisenberg state model. And a typical property of Heisenberg model composed of orientation and scalar components is the development of strong OD scalar peaks near singular points, because orientation components vanish near singular centers. Such as scalar structure or scalar peak is called by out of plane vortex in magnetism and island patterns in visual vortex. this figure, relatively speaking, the joint model of OP and OD map formation should be reflected by an isotropic Heisenberg model because of the asymmetry between OP and OD maps. And this graph shows how much OD component or scalar component develops depending on the anisotropy lambda. Here, lambda is defined by the ratio of ground state energy of OP and OD maps. In consideration of the classical anisotropic Heisenberg model. This is pure Heisenberg model, at which lambda equals 1. And in this Heisenberg model region, strong OD components develop with parallel band patterns. This is the typical properties of OD map, which is generated without OP maps. And in this XI model region, there is another boundary at this critical point above which out-of-plane vortex or island band patterns can develop. This property is first introduced in the study of the classical fluid on a Heisenberg model by these two Japanese people in 1980. And of the critical points, no OD map patterns develops. This graph, this result show you that the brains can have at least three different kinds of pattern types, and we can find corresponding data in animal experiments. This figure shows the three typical visual map types observed in different animals. This macaque monk have the same corresponding of visual maps in rising model region, and this is in this case of cat, they have highlighted patterns in body maps, and Trishu have no body maps. Instead, they have strong orientation selectivity. So, both people reflect orientation orientation preference map by that of Trishu. It's a summary. I show you the collective behaviors in a context that can be classified the general principles in statistical mechanics in spite of unique neural mechanisms and complex cortical structures. And we give a current interpretation of the diverse phenomena in the visual cortex visual map formation with the help of the universal theory in physics or analysis in speech systems. Thank you.